Best of r/entitled parents episode 118. Subscribe for Reddit videos daily. M. Mommy S. Entitled sister me. Me D. Dad S. O. Significant other. Alright y'all, who's ready for another roller coaster? Please pardon my text time on mobile. So context. I was in the a couple of weeks ago for a health condition. Now I'm on anti-inflammatory medication and considered high risk for COVID-19. So if I get sick with this, there's a good chance I'll get hospital level sick. Not only that, but because of COVID, my mom and pop shop I work at has closed and I'm unemployed until further notice. Next thing to note is I'm 23F and she's 22F. This will be important later. Now for the story. My sister is getting married in August and her bridal shower is in 3 weeks. I just got the invite to go. So I text my sister. Me. Hey, yes, I'm not going to be able to RSVP in 1 week on time. I really need to see how your state handles the virus so I can do a proper risk management assessment for my health. Yes, so you're not going? Okay, I'm registered at Walmart, Amazon, and Target. Me, that's the thing, me and S. O are both unemployed due to the virus, so I was gonna get you a slightly more expensive present for your wedding because finances are gonna be really tight until this is over. Yes. So first you're not going to my bridal shower, then you aren't going to send me a present? You're the oldest. Set an example for the younger ones. Me. Well, it's kinda rude of you to tell me to 1. Drive the 4 hours to your bridal shower and then back. 2. Risk my health for it, and 3. Tell me that I should still buy you a present when I am unemployed. Yes, this virus will maybe kill 3% of people tops. You'll be fine. Everyone will wash their hands and no one's gonna bring germs. Me, you don't know who everyone has or is going to be around. Like I said, I will go if things get better. Yes, ugh, you're such a bitch. You're just jealous that I'm getting married before you and I'm younger and all you have is living together with S. O adds mom, tell OP she has to come to my bridal shower. M. You're not going to your own sister's bridal shower. OP, are you at least getting her something off of her registry? Me. I'm unemployed due to the virus, remember? I was gonna get her something a bit bigger for the wedding, but I really can't afford a present and gas right now. If I was to go, I would be the gift. M. This is inappropriate of you to do. Your sister did nothing to you. She works 40 hours a week at a nursing home. You work at a place where you get to play all day. Me. If she has a job at a nursing home, she shouldn't be having this anyway. What happened to working at the bridal shop? Yes. None of your business. Now are you coming or not? Me. I said I would reevaluate when the virus calms down. Yes. If mom won't talk any sense into you, then maybe dad will. Add dad to chat. D. Your sister will do what she wants. She's unemployed and could get sick. I can hear you screaming from the downstairs. I'm trying to play cribbage with ES fiance. Let it go, figure it out yourself. Stop calling her a bitch to your younger sisters and friends upstairs. ES. But she's being a baby. D. If you wanted her to feel wanted at any of these events, maybe you should have invited her to your dress shopping instead of saying that all of your real sisters were there when she wasn't. Now, like I said, we are playing cribbage. Leave me out of this. M. No wonder I divorced him, he's such a coward. Side note, he divorced her after coming back from Iraq. Me. Alright, I'm leaving this conversation. I'll tell you my decision in 2 weeks. Yes. OP, I'll be sending you the registry. Please pick something from the second tier of needs and wants or the top. THXS. Can't wait to see you at the bridal shower. Thank you. Next. Never would I ever expect a Karen in my neighborhood. But there she is in all her glory. Not my story. My son's. However, I'll tell it as I'm beyond mad. I'm on a mobile. My spelling sucks beyond. I'm a auto shop teacher, so I don't have good grammar. English is my third language, but I grew up in the US, so I will try. It's been a long week and getting any exercise is almost impossible. So I built in walks for my son to do during the day. Mainly so he doesn't become a sloth and so the dog can get out. Dog is an American Pit Bull Terrier, or Nanny Dog. They were originally bred to nanny while mom and dad worked on the farm. In no way are they born killers. That's a training they get. Pup was abandoned, and to despite that, she's beyond loving and trusting. We fostered her but discovered that if we sent her off to another family, after being jumbled around from foster to foster, her love and trust would go away. We are foster fails. We have two mean cats. They will kill birds, possums, and anything they think they can kill. You now know the dynamics. Onto the short story. Boy was walking pup and minding his distance from everyone. No one is out, so he's good. Then he happens upon a house with a woman and her child in their driveway. Boy crosses the street as we taught him, mainly because pup is a pit bull and people are nuts. The dog is a killer. He, it's a she, should be killed. Boy was stunned. He didn't say anything at first. Just reached into his pockets to get his phone to call me. Give me your dog. He needs to die. I'm sure he's killed and tasted blood. I bet he kills birds. Remember my cats do, but pup? Nope, she's just a love. That's when my son got real scared and told the lady to F off. He was so shaken. If you follow me, I will call the police. Nothing has happened yet. However, I'm going to take pup for a walk at the same time tomorrow and see if she's out. I'm beyond mad. One, there are several pit bulls in this neighborhood. Two, who do you think you are, trying to take a pet from a kid? And three, how did the Karen move in without us knowing? Pup has been here 6 months and we walk her daily. She should have seen us. Okay, that's all. Thanks for reading. Edit. Thank you all for your kind words. To the ones who believe that nanny dogs were not a thing, well, I guess my grandparents, who are all gone as they would be over 100 now, were wrong when they told me their stories of growing up. It's good to hear that. Oh wait, I believe the people who grew up in that day and age, not the ones who decide what's true and not. Thank you. Next. Hi, this is my first post on here, though I have looked at these stories a lot. In my middle school class, there is this kid that is the absolute definition of an idiot. Smokes every day after school, and has gotten suspended for it, does no homework, and fails all of his tests if he can't find someone to copy off of, which he usually does. All the teachers hate him, but his parents are rich and donate a lot to the school, so he hasn't been expelled. Since we are going to high school next year, we have to meet with the guidance counselor and pick our subjects we are going to take. The rule is that you have to maintain an A or higher to get into honors subjects in high school, except for math. Since this kid has an average of D, he can't get into any honors other than math. One day, I had forgotten my lunch at home, so my parents dropped it off at the front office, and I went to pick it up. In front of me in line to the desk was the parent of this, we'll call him IK for idiot kid, yelling at the receptionist. This is where the story begins. We'll use EM for entitled mom and R for receptionist. EM, why didn't my son get into honors? R, please don't yell, miss. What was your son's name? EM tells her the name, and the receptionist pulls up his grades. R, so it looks here that your son doesn't have the grades required too. EM, I don't care about the grades. If you people actually gave him the chance to thrive, then he would be the best in the school. R, I'm sorry, but I don't influence the GRA. EM, then get someone useful. R, I'm sorry, miss. It's really too late in the school year to change his average by that much. So, EM, I don't care about the grades. Just put him in the honors classes. I fucking own this school. I donated so much money, I should get a say in what he can and cannot do. Ah, I'm sorry, but you can bring it up with the superintendent if you want to do something. The EM stormed out, and I picked up my lunch and left. It turns out that the EM got some strings pulled when she contacted the superintendent, and IK got into the honors program. He lasted, I kid you not, 3 weeks, before getting kicked out for failing. The kid later got sent to live with his aunt because he almost killed someone in a fight, and the parents didn't want to tarnish their reputation with that kind of behavior. What's said about this story is that I don't really think the EM actually cared about her kid, but wanted to maintain her reputation by having a son go into all honors. Sorry for the long post. TLDR. Kid has terrible grades so can't get into honors. So rich mom yells at the receptionist, then gets strings pulled so the kid gets in, and he doesn't last very long. Thank you. Next. The entitled part is later down the text. So as you may all know, there is an outbreak of coronavirus which is spreading at a great speed. Now my parents, though this was a good time to go to countries such as going to Vietnam and a few days later going to Bali. After hearing this, I told them this was not a good idea, but as entitled as they are, they just told me not to worry. Now, This was the time where governments around the world were having stricter borders and more checks. My parents, on the other hand, just to me and the rest of my family that they would not go to quarantine in any case as they would be fine. A couple days before they were due to leave Vietnam, they sent us a picture of them in the streets, visiting, but not caring about what they were touching. After going to Singapore, they got a flight to Bali. Yet again, they did not care much about the restrictions that were placed or what they touched around the place. They did tell us that some policemen told them that they had to go back to their hotel. They told the policeman okay. As they were walking back, they doubled back to visit some more. Now here comes the entitled part. On the flight back to Singapore, they were told that everybody was to go to quarantine, and if they didn't agree, they would be expelled from the country. My mom was to go back to New Zealand later, and after the plane landed, she steamed towards the custom area and told them, "I will be put into quarantine." The custom officers, clearly in shock, told them she would have to. "I am going to New Zealand and I will not be staying a full 2 weeks in quarantine." Now my father works in Singapore and calmed agreed to the other officers that he would go to self-quarantine. After about a quarter hour arguing with the custom officer, police officers, my mum was allowed to go to NZ and be put there in quarantine as long as she had to put a mask and also be by herself at the front of the plane. From my point of view, her strategy was extremely dangerous and risky, and could put people in hospital if she was infected. BTW, this is only from my father's point of view which was relayed to us. This is because I'm in France stuck into isolation. TLDR. My mum argues to officers to not be put into quarantine. Thank you. Next. I work in a preschool and sometimes babysit kids from work, especially when we are on break. Because of coronavirus, we are cancelled. Because my sister has a disability and is immunocompromised, my whole family agreed to go into self-isolation. Thankfully, most of us can work from home. We would limit our contact with all others, even other family members, to protect my sister. I was playing outside in the driveway with my brothers, when a familiar car pulls up, and one of the little girls, let's call her Susie, from the preschool gets out of the car. I have babysat her many times before, but never agreed to on this occasion. I assumed the mom was going to ask me to watch her, but when I approach the car, she speeds off, leaving poor Susie there. I had not made any previous arrangements to watch her, and didn't want to let her enter my house, knowing her father is a frequent flyer and Susie may be a carrier. I got her some water and let her sit down in the garage to get her out of the wind as I tried calling her mom and dad. Neither picked up at first, until I finally got a hold of a very angry mom. I explained I couldn't watch Susie, and she would have to come back and pick her up. The mom freaked out, saying she was already at work. This is a total lie. She works at a mall that I know for a fact is closed because of coronavirus. I tell her that if she doesn't return within a half hour, how far the mall is from my house, I will be calling CPS. She knows we are mandatory reporters because we already had to open a case on her. She explains that she can't but says she will send her husband. 15 minutes passes, and then 30. I get Susie some chalk to color with while maintaining a distance but trying to keep her happy. An hour later, I know no one is coming to get her. I phone CPS and the non-emergency police line, and police arrive at my house in a couple minutes. I explain to them the whole situation, and thankfully a CPS worker is able to get there pretty quickly. The mom phones me later and yells at me for Susie being taken by CPS and them having another investigation, saying I always watch Susie during break. I explain my immunocompromised sister, and she is very offended. I even suggested Susie might be sick. I didn't even bother to explain how she could be a carrier without showing symptoms. EM claims she won't be returning Susie to our preschool because of my appalling and disrespectful behavior, but I know that she has been kicked out of all the other preschools. I wouldn't mind if EM never came back, but I would certainly feel bad for little Susie. I'll try to remember to update this post when school is back in session. Stay safe and healthy, y'all. Thank you. Next. M equals entitled mother. CK equals curious kid. GF equals girlfriend. S equals security. For a little bit of background, I am in a lesbian relationship and neither of us put up with shit. A couple years ago, I went to the movies with my girlfriend. I don't remember what we watched, as we were leaving the theater and went to go over to the arcade. This kid about 6-7 walks up to us. This is the conversation that took place. CK, Hi lady, can I ask you a question? GF, UHH, okay, CK, why were you kissing that girl? GF, because I love her. CK, my mommy said that only boys and girls can love each other. Op, well sometimes a boy and a boy or a girl and a girl fall in love with each other. And in walks entitled mother. CK, that's my mommy. Me, realizing what's about to happen. Oh shit M, excuse me, GF. Yes, M, are you infecting my child with your disgusting faggotry? Op, excuse me? CK, what does faggotry mean? Op, it's a mean word for people who are gay. CK, what's gay? M, these disgust GF, who just interrupted M. Two boys or two girls who love each other a lot are called gay. CK, I love my daddy. Am I gay? Op, it's a different kind of love, like how your mommy loves your daddy. M, stop corrupting my child with your disgusting bullshit. Security comes over, hearing the noise. S, excuse me ladies, what's going on here? M, get these disgusting pigs out of here. S, what were they doing? M, corrupting my son with sin. S, excuse me, come again? 1/2 hour later. S, Sue, this child asked some questions, you answered them, and this woman is committing a hate crime? GF, pretty much. Security then pulled M aside and talked with her. I didn't hear the full conversation, but mostly screaming. Security then pulled us aside and after explaining what happened, we started laughing. M, what's so funny? Apparently, the security guard had M's record being read to her by a coworker. M was being charged for child abuse and child neglect. We both had our IDs out and I had never seen realization hit someone so hard, so fast. I saw M's face go from normal to red to white as she took a closer look at my GF Sid. My girlfriend works for child services. Let's just say M got kicked out from the mall. Thank you. Next. I've been on a terribly timed holiday to the UK since the beginning of March, and returned today to my home city. Understandably, there's loads of people wearing masks, warnings everywhere, and people trying to distance themselves and wary of others. It's not quite full-blown panic, but people are very wary. I even saw several travelers in full hazmat type cotton suits and eye goggles and masks and gloves. Anyway, my last leg of my flight, I was assigned a window seat in a 3-seat row. I get there and there's a lady and a small girl, looks about 5-6, both with masks on. As soon as I gesture to sit, the mum pipes up and says, oh, I just want you to know we both have a cough, so you probably want to sit somewhere else. I've already talked to the crew. The crew member then passes and I ask if they have a seat, and she says to first have a seat in my original seat and wait until everyone has boarded. I then offer to sit in the aisle seat for the moment so that if I move it's easy. The mum keeps saying, oh yeah, but I just thought you should move. I really think you'd be more comfortable. Apostrophe. So I sit for the moment because there's people still boarding and putting bags up etc etc. Now unfortunately the flight ends up being delayed about an hour and a half due to some passengers being offloaded due to temperature screening. During this waiting time I sort of look around to see what other seats are available. It looks like a pretty full flight, but there are a couple empty seats. But we don't know who else is getting on still. I'm also feeling a bit conflicted. It's a very long 13-hour flight and I don't want to move to a crappy seat stuck between two strangers or something. But I also want to be careful and avoid people with symptoms. Now during this waiting time the mum and daughter keep whispering to each other and really often coughing, with masks on, conspicuously and painfully. Happily, the crew member comes back and waves. I have a window seat in the front row with more leg room and an empty seat next to me as well. Lovely. Usually you need to pay more for those. So I move. Then later I pass the mum and daughter again and guess what? Neither wearing masks, looking happy and healthy and comfortable with an empty seat next to them. The little girl probably got to lie down and sleep. Now I don't begrudge the girl having a nice rest on what is a very tiring long flight. She was a very well-behaved girl as well. What makes me really furious is that either A, they had such severe symptoms, which they demonstrated conspicuously when trying to convince me to move, and took off their masks. B, the mum lied about having symptoms and took advantage of the pandemic and the global fear to get themselves an extra empty seat. Seriously off you entitled bitch. If she just asked nicely and told the truth, I would have moved anyway because there was a nicer seat available. But what if there wasn't? I might have made the decision to move to a worse seat because she scared me into thinking they might be contagious. Scum.